Guys, we're gonna call Dr. Post now, ready? Dr. Pilch, are you there?
No.
How's your day going so far?
It's going really well.
Enjoying a coffee?
I don't drink coffee.
My day's going great. Thanks for asking. Well, listen, we need to talk to you about something really important the fourth grade is planning to do. You know how every year we put on a play, right?
Right.
Well, this year we had a new idea. We created a game show. And since it was so clever, we decided to take it to the next level. You want to know what the next level is? Well, the next level is we need money.
Dr. Pilch?
Yes.
Are you still there?
I hope so.
Yeah, that's right. We need money!
I heard you loud and clear, we do too.
There have to be prizes for the game show, because what do people like better than money? Am I right? Anyway, we contacted Mr. Whitevich in the business office, and he helped us set up a new game show account. He said that we would have to tell you about it.
I'm glad he said that.
So now we're telling you about it. What?
Yeah, that's great. I'd love to hear more.
You don't think this is legal?
Some challenges.
No problem. We've taken care of all that and everyone's on board. Our people would be happy to talk to your people about it.
That makes me nervous.
Who are our people? Oh, we have people. I'm just not sure who they are right now, but we do have people. Anyway, we have Kieran Rebalt crunching the numbers right now. Educational game show. The fourth graders will play for money and then use the money to pay for all their field trips. It's a win-win situation. We're doing a trial run in the morning. Can you come down to the lower school this morning? Oh, by the way, the show is called Who's Smarter Than a Fourth Grader?
Don't you just love the name? We needed celebrity guests to play against the kids. And since we couldn't get Justin Bieber, or Lady Gaga, we decided to get some more interesting people, and we certainly found them. What? You're wondering if you're a celebrity guest? No. Not at this particular time. Maybe you could play another day?
Let me tell you how the game is played. Fourth grade teachers will ask questions based on what the fourth graders should have learned this year. The kids will be playing against a celebrity guest. Whoever gets the question right wins the money. Doesn't this sound like a great idea? You're not sure? Well, come and see for yourself. We have a whole studio audience waiting. Gotta go. Bye.
That's right, folks. We hope the kids can win lots of money, too. We have our celebrity guests, our teachers, and our kids.
all ready to play. Who's smarter than a fourth grader? Please turn off your cell phones, because if we hear you ringing, we will find you in the audience and make you one of our next victims. Celebrities. So right here, right now, let's play.
Who's smarter than a fourth grader?
So excited to present it to you. Our talented teachers will be asking questions of our fourth graders and a mystery guest to see who will win the prize money. The mystery guest will always get to guess first. Our first teacher comes to us all the way from the science room. Let's put our hands together for Miss Mercy.
I am so happy to be here. I will be asking science questions, and I have brought with me an important scientist as my guest celebrity. Please welcome Alfred Nobel.
Thank you. Oh, stop it. I'm Swedish, and I'm dead. But I was once a famous chemist. So I hope I get some vintage ready and win some money.
First question, please.
Question number one. This year we study nutrition, and I'd like to know what is meant by the cereal aisle.
We eat a lot of herring in Sweden, but I don't think there's a herring cereal, is there?
No, I don't think so. Fourth grade.
Roger.
The cereal aisle is in most supermarkets, and it's very attractive. That's how it gets people to buy it, especially children. This year, that's called consumerism. This year in science, we made our own cereal boxes and made up a brand on the cover, put nutrition facts on the side, and even put a fun zone on the back for kids. And that's what all the cereal aisle is meant by.
Good answer, Roger. You're the scientist of the day. High five. All right. The next question is about owls. What is an owl pellet?
Owl pellet. Do you mix it with water and you get an owl?
No. Sorry, Mr. Nobel. Fourth grade. Anna.
Owls are birds of prey. That means they hunt to eat. At night, owls catch and eat small rodents, birds, and bugs. Their stomach can't digest the fur, bones, teeth, and shells, and yummy extra delicacies. From a tight pile in the owl's stomach and later gets there. It's really gross, but surprisingly fun to examine an owl pellet.
Hannah, that answer was fantastic. The next question is about electricity. What happens when you flip a light switch on and off?
That's an unfair question. I don't think electricity has been invented yet.
Well, maybe not in your time. Fourth grade? Chantelle.
When you flip a light switch on and off, you open and close a circuit. That's a path for electricity to follow. The circuit must be closed for electrons to travel and create a current. When you flip the light switch off, you open the circuit and the lights go off. The lights turn on when the circuit is closed. Couldn't you have brought Thomas Edison to be a celebrity?
Chantelou, I am not shocked by your excellent answer. And yes, Edison would have been a better choice, but he's dead too. The next question is about birds. Name seven birds that cannot fly and describe at least one of them.
I know something about birds, but I can only talk about them in Swedish.
Sorry, we don't understand Swedish. Fourth grade? Zoe.
Seven birds that are flightless are the emu, the ostrich, the turkey, the kiwi, the penguin, the rhea, and the dodo. I want to tell you about the dodo today, because no one really talks about it. No one really cares about it. And I know some facts about it. The dodo is an extinct flightless bird that is related to the pigeon. It died out in about 1680. Before it became extinct, some artists painted pictures of it, so we know what it looks like today.
Very good, Zoe. You are flying high with that answer. We've come to the last question, Mr. Nobel. You might know this one, even though it looks very difficult. What is Kielsinger?
I know that word. Kielsinger.
So I just can't think of it right now. I'm dead, you know.
Wow, Miss Nobel, I can't believe a famous chemist like you couldn't answer any of the questions. That's just plain sad. Fourth grade? Zach.
Kielsinger is a type of chalky earth. When combined with nitroglycerin, it makes a very powerful explosive. A well-known Swedish chemist named Alfred Nobel discovered Kielsinger.
But I am Alfred Nobel. This is unfair. You should have won.
Sorry, Mr. Nobel. I can't believe you didn't get any of the answers right. It could be because you're dead. Anyway, this very powerful explosive you discovered is called dynamite. Ring a bell?
I knew it! Dynamite!
I came to dance. I need the flow, cause that's my plans. I'm wearing all my favorite plans. We need some space for both my hands. You can go on alone.
Gotta let go. I wanna celebrate and live my life. a great first round, wasn't it, folks? I believe the kids won $5,000. Is that right, kid?
This is a great start. The kids have won $5,000.
Good thing we got that prize money from Dr. Coach. Sometimes our fourth graders have trouble learning how to be a good friend. Our next teacher helps the whole school with that. Let's welcome Mrs. L and see who she brought with her today.
Why, thank you, Brennan. I'd like to introduce my special guest, Woody, from the movie Toy Story. He might have trouble answering, well, because he's a toy, and he isn't able to talk when grown-ups are around.
Oh, this could be a little awkward. Well, let's get started.
Okay, here's the first question. Why did we decide to write and publish the book, A Letter to the President?
It's okay, Woody. Fourth grade. Sorry.
Well, we read President Obama's book of the essay, and we were so inspired by it that we decided to write to him. And we even used the same format. So we started each page with a sentence like, "Have I told you you are courageous?" and drew a picture of the person and wrote about them too. FYI, you can buy a copy of our book after the show for yourself.
Great job, Sachi. All right, question two. What were the character traits that some of the famous people displayed, and what character traits do you use while writing the book?
I don't think toys have any character traits.
Well, Woody, I mean, you're a character. You have traits, right? Oh, fourth grade. Thanks.
Some of the famous people displayed courage, independence, confidence, adventuresome spirit, and generosity. When we were writing this book, we had to be patient, polite, dependable, and cooperative. We learned a lot from writing this book, and we are proud of it. We're going to send it to President Obama.
Great answer, David. All right, question number three. We talk a lot about choices and consequences. If you were working nearby and you saw some kids taking candy from Mrs. Van Horn's closet, what would you do?
I would start to live in Mrs. Van Horn's closet.
That's not really an option, Woody. I'm in fourth grade. Matt?
Well, first of all, I wouldn't participate. They are making a bad choice, and there will be bad consequences. Trust me, I know. They know stealing is wrong. They probably just stared at each other to do it. If I couldn't talk them into stopping what they were doing, I would probably find a grown-up to help.
Good thinking, Matt. Okay, question number four. Imagine that someone is in reading class, and that person has a little trouble and stumbles over a word, and then the other kids start to giggle. How would you respond?
Well, can't they see him having trouble responding at all?
Fourth grade. Lauren.
Well, I might try to give the person who laughed a look to let them know that they shouldn't be laughing. That's just me. Not everyone is comfortable reading out loud, and that person was probably trying their best. After class, I might tell the reader that they did a good job, and I would talk to the person that laughed too.
That would be very kind, Lauren. All right, here's our last question. Who is a great example of a really good friend?
It's okay, Woody. I'll help you. I know you're a toy and you're not supposed to talk in front of grown-ups, but it's okay. They're our parents and our teachers. They're very friendly and very nice. If you want, you can whisper the answer to me and I'll say it for you. What's that? You think you can say it by yourself? That's great. I'm right here beside you. You can do it.
Well, I don't like to brag, but I think I'm an exceptionally good friend. Like it says Buzz or Bullseye, they'll tell you. To have a good friend, you gotta be a good friend. You gotta stick it out through good times and bad times. And as I always tell my friends, you've got a friend in me.
We have to keep both our brains and bodies healthy and strong.
Who have you brought with you today to go up against our smart fourth graders?
I was lucky enough to bring Roy Oswalt and one of the star pitchers from the Phillies to be my guest. Hey.
Welcome, Roy. All right, first question, Mr. Spears.
What is Scholastics?
Scholastics? Isn't that the team we play from Steelville? I don't think that's a place, Roy. Fourth grade? Trillium?
Roy, I hate to break it down to you, but Scholastics is an exercise game. We're on teams and we roll the dice to move the beanbag around the mat. The pictures on the mat are exercises. The whole team has to do the exercise. The idea of this game is to move the beanbag around the mat doing the exercises. First team who gets around the mat first wins.
That's right, Trillium. Great job. Next question. What is the Titanic Challenge?
The Titanic? Who cares about the Titanic? Let's say, like 100 years ago.
Oh, brother. Fourth grade? Ethan?
Well, we play the Titanic Challenge in gym. There are 5 hula hoops, which are our lifeboats. The object of this game is to get from one side of the gym to the other. You have to step in the hula hoops, because if you don't, you'll drown and have to start over. This game takes a lot of strategy and working together as a team.
All right, good answer, Ethan. The next question is, what is a fourth grade walking program all about?
Well, unfortunately, I walk a few minutes every now and then.
Not that kind of walk, Roy. Fourth grade? Phoebe?
In the gym lobby, there is a big map of Pennsylvania with historic landmarks on it. Fourth graders walk laps in the morning, and Mrs. Spears keeps track of our progress. We start an area at the beginning of the year and hopefully earn enough miles so that we end up near Philadelphia by the end of the year.
Good answer, Phoebe. Here's a question I wanted to ask for a long time. What do the fourth graders find so appealing about bombardment?
Bombardment? Never heard of it.
Never heard of a lot of things, Roy. Fourth grade. Logan?
Bombardment is so cool. It's the 3X. It's fast, it's fun, and it's fantastic. When I'm tired after school, I can get so pumped up for bombardment. We get in our teams, the music starts, and the balls begin to fly. It's even fun when you're out and you can sit on the sidelines and watch. Bombardment is so cool.
All right, Logan, good answer. All right, here's the last question, Roy, and you have to answer something. Here's one I'm sure you'll know. What position does your buddy Shane Victorino play?
Victorino? He's that guy from Hawaii, right? Let's see. Ruiz is the catcher, Powers at first. Where does Shane play? Can I call a friend?
Why not?
Hello? Is Shane there? Can I speak to him?
Oh, come on, Roy. You're the pitcher. Don't you go on the field with you? Oh, he's at second. Plunk is on third. Ron's that short. Francisco's in right. Abani's in left. And Shane Victorino plays center field. Everyone's that. He plays center field.
The sun came out today. We're born.
something like this, folks. The fourth graders are adding up their winnings. How much do they have now, Kieran?
$15,000. I think that they can afford to have new laptops for the whole school.
Wouldn't that be something? We know our students have to be ready for the 21st century learning. One place they work hard is in the computer lab. Learning the keyboard is a first step, and who would be better to help train their little fingers than our own Mrs. Finger herself?
Thank you very much. And honestly, I really never thought of that joke before. My husband's the third of five, and he's known as the middle finger. All right, anyway. Thanks for asking me to be on the show, and I have a very exciting guest with me. It's Mr. Steve Jobs, CEO of Apple Computers.
Oh my, I don't know how the fourth graders will do against him. He knows everything about computers.
All right, well, let's just see. Okay, question number one. What is a wiki, and how did it get its name?
Mr. Jobs. Mr. Jobs. Oh, fourth grade. Oh, Lord.
A wiki is a website that allows anyone to add, delete, or change the information using a web browser. When the guy who developed the first wiki was at the Honolulu, Hawaii airport, someone told him to take the wiki bus because it would get him where he needed to go quickly. Wiki is a Polynesian word meaning quick. He thought wiki was a catchy name.
Ooh, very interesting, Lauren. Okay, question number two. How did the Apple Computer Company get its name?
What was the question again? Hold on, I'm getting a call. Yeah, hi. Of course I'm gonna go off for playing together.
Are you really that important, Steve?
Yeah!
Fourth grade. Allison.
Boy, for a big deal CEO, he sure isn't doing very well. You'd think he'd be able to answer questions about his own company. Apple Computers got their name because he, Mr. Jobs there, worked in Apple Orchard one summer and loved it so much he decided to name his company after it. The name Mac comes from Macintosh. Apple's are some of his favorites. Is he just going to play on his phone and not participate?
Yes.
Honestly, I don't really know what he's doing or why we even invite him. But let's just see. What are five good rules to follow for internet safety?
I'm too busy working on the iPhone 5 to answer that. It's gonna be a hit, and you have to work on things that are going to be a hit.
Okay, you're on a game show, you know, right?
Well, I'm on a game show? There's a hurrah contest!
Oh, fourth grade. Zach.
Five rules for internet safety are: 1. Always ask an adult before using the internet. 2. Keep all personal information to yourself. 3. Never share your password with anyone other than your parents. 4. Don't meet an online friend in person. And 5. Be kind and use good netiquette.
Actually, it's netiquette. But very good. And by the way, personal information is your name, your address, your phone number, and any other identifying information. Okay, last question. No, one more to go after that. Before hitting the trail, when you play Oregon Trail, name some of the items that you must bring before you'll be able to depart.
What's in Oregon? Let me see what my iPad says.
I'm pretty sure that's against the rules. Fourth grade. Matthew.
I know you need to bring lots of provisions in your covered wagon. You'll need to bring flour and sugar and some other preserved foods. Some clothes to wear and some furniture to sit on. Some seeds for planting and tools for building a cabin and repairing the wagon. Oh, and everyone must have at least 6 oxen before they are allowed to depart.
You are right, Matthew. All right, last question. Finish this phrase and then explain what it means. If you wouldn't say it in person,
who taught?
talks to people anymore. I only text.
Wait, I'll take that. Thank you.
About what you're gonna say when you're online. Sometimes you might think of something to say online that you would never say if you were looking right at that person. Be careful that you don't gossip or say anything mean online, or you could get in trouble.
Excellent. That's exactly right, Erin. And you know what? I just thought of one more thing. Steve, listen, you've not been paying attention at all during this game.
And I completely disagree with that opinion.
I don't really know how you can disagree with that. You have to be kind when you're online. But let me talk, please, because you're bumping into my words. Okay, here we go. Last thing that I just thought of. Do you think that in the future, electronic devices will replace teachers?
Are you ready? Can you count to 100 by tens beginning with 10? Uno, dos, tres.
I think that's Spanish. Fourth grade. William.
That's easy. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100.
Désolé, chouchou. I meant to say, can you count en français, of course.
Why didn't you just say so?
I forgot.
10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. I have a pretty good French accent, don't I?
Félicitations! Félicitations!
Félicitations!
You do, William. Question numéro 2. The fleur-de-lis is an important French symbol. What does it represent?
I don't think we have one of those on Sesame Street.
Oh, yeah.
That's okay, Ernie. I'm sure there are other flowers on Sesame Street. Fourth grade. Sarah.
Fleur means flower, and leaves means lily. The fleur-de-lis looks like a plant with three leaves. Some historians believe the leaves stood for the different social classes at the time. Those who worked, those who fought, and those who played. It's a symbol used all over France, revenge kings and queens, and even appears on flags and some postage stamps.
Très bien, Sarah. Félicitations. Let's see now. How well do you know the parts of the body?
I'm a Muppet. I might not have the same body parts as your kid. I'm sure you have some of the same body parts. Anyway, fourth grade. Ethan.
Oh, Ethan, tu es prêt? Oui, chouchou? Ok. Qu'est-ce que c'est que ça?
La tête.
La tête, très bien. Qu'est-ce que c'est que ça?
Le nez.
Très bien. Et ça?
L'œil.
Très bien. Et ça?
La bouche.
La bouche. Ça?
Le cou.
Et ça?
L'estomac.
Bravo, Ethan. Excellent.
We know about 40 parts of the body in French. We have a joke in class because the word la fesse, which sounds like the word face, is the French word for touch. And as we say in fourth grade, your hyena. We have a joke in class because Manon points to her face to throw us off and we always laugh.
Oh, Ethan, you are a funny one. Question numero 4. What did we learn about Joan of Arc this year?
I don't know.
Oh, Ernie.
It's okay, Ernie. Maybe you'll get the next one. Fourth grade. Lucy.
When Jeanne d'Arc was a young girl in France, she began to hear voices in her head. They were the voices of saints, telling her that she needed to go to war to defend the young heir to the throne of France. Joan went bravely into battle, but was later found guilty of witchcraft and was burned at the stake. Isn't that awful? But the prince she defended was later crowned King Charles VII of France.
Excellent, Lucie. Félicitations. This is the last question, and poor Ernie must have a chance. Ernie, this one's for you. Toi.
Oh,
you like a beautiful name. Can you name an animal en français that makes the noise? Quack, quack.
I can. I know this one. I know how to say duck in French. Le canard. I love ducks. In fact, I have one right
now. Oh, bravo, Ernie. Le canard.
And I made up a song for you, Nelfugo, to thank you for all that you taught me. And I even taught it to everyone else, so we can sing it for you today. It's the tune of Le canard et Caoutchouc, or Rubber Ducky.
Merci, Ernie. Merci.
Anyway. We have one last round to play this morning, and because it's the last round, the stakes are high. The kids will be playing for $25,000. Right, Karen? Mr. W, was that in the script? Anyway, the topic of our last round is a topic everyone loves, music. And here to play our game with us this morning is our wonderful music teacher, Mrs. Olson.
Thanks for having me, Allie. I love playing this game with these adorable children.
And who did you invite as your celebrity guest?
Well, my celebrity guest isn't, doesn't seem to be here yet. What shall we do?
Well, we'll have to start without him or her. What are the advantages for the fourth graders?
Well, question number one, name a composer from the Baroque period who had 21 children.
Eminem?
That would be Johann Sebastian Bach. He was German and one of the greatest composers of all time. But during his lifetime, he was not very well known. When Bach was younger, he played the violin and harpsichord. He composed 1,100 musical works. Four out of his 21 children became famous musicians too. Hey, that gets me thinking. Mom, can I have 18 more sisters?
Question number two. What is the game we like to play to practice crescendo and decrescendo?
Isabella?
It's Lucy Locket. It goes.
Lucy Locket lost her pocket, Kitty Fisher found it. Not a penny was there in it, only ribbon round it.
When we get louder, which is crescendo, and then we get softer, which is decrescendo. It's a fun way to learn music.
That was lovely, Isabella. Question number three. I know you all love to play garage band. What are the musical categories found there? And what are some of the loops that you like?
Ellen.
The categories are jazz, blues, rock, country, reggae, slow blues, and funk. I like all the loops, but the ones I like to use when I write music on GarageBand are drums, guitar, electric piano, and percussion. We get some real music going on in music class, don't we, Mrs. Wilson?
We sure do, Ellie. Now question number four. Why did we sing a song called Salah Salou at our spring concert a few weeks ago? What was that all about?
Perry?
Salah Salou is an imaginary place from Seussical the Musical by Dr. Seuss. It's a magical place where they never have troubles, at least very few. One of the characters is trying to get to Salah Salou because he thinks all of his problems will go away. He realizes that his problems follow him everywhere.
Excellent answer, Perry. Well, this is the last question of the show. Now, you children may not believe this about me, but I do have one little secret. I sometimes like to watch rock and roll music videos on YouTube. Well, if only my mystery guest would show up now, he could help me with this question. I don't know if any of you know the answer to this question, but what music video was filmed at the Exton Drive-In Theater in 1986?
Oh no, that was really long ago. We weren't alive in 1986. My parents hadn't even thought of me.
Let's see, who were the big stars in 1986? Madonna? Bon Jovi, Bruce Springsteen, the Bengals, Bananarama.
Help! What are we going to do? If we can't.
Hold on.
Brazilian, one of the original members of the Hooters, and we're going to do this song now. Who feels like dancing?